people, and they are going to be doing a tutorial on how to run water for your Immersive Railroading train. But a lot of people are asking comments on how to do it, or how I do it. So here's a bit of a tutorial. So what you're going to need is you'll need some treated wood, you need iron sheet metal, you're going to need some cooler pipes, a fluid loader, which is a fulgurant. You're going to need something that supplies power, some wire relays here, insulated wire coil, and a fluid pump. So how you, first thing we do is we make the water tower, which is where the water is going to be stored. So you do four blocks like this. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So it's a 3x3. You put a sheet metal in the middle. And then what you do is you go one up again. Then you do another one. Then you do another one. Then you do top like that. So it should be 4 high, 5 high in total. You're going to need your trusty hammer, which is, where is it, this one here, you need hammer, and you right click it. So there's your fluid tank. What you are also going to need is you're going to need somewhere to put the water up top. I generally make my own sort of water pit, purely based on its plane creating, so I don't need to worry about generating water and all that sort of stuff. I do like to make it a little bit realistic though, so I do all this stuff with the concrete. What you want to do is you want to put a block here. You want to put your fluid pump on the end like this. You want to do that, yeah? Then what you want to do is you want to grab your hammer, you want to make that an outlet. You'll get your pipe, put it here, 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 and then you want to go up. I do up because generally solos are filled from the top, not from the bottom. You can do it in this block now. You want a lever so that you can switch this on and off. So it's in the off at the moment, so we'll leave it like that. You want a LV wire connector. What you can do is, what I usually do is I usually build a, so back today, I usually build a building to put this capacitor in so it looks a bit more realistic. For the sake of this exercise, you're not going to worry about it. You guys can work out the best way for you to hide this, make it look like it's, you know, part of an electric building or something. I can show you an example of what I've done a bit later on if you guys want to watch the video. So there's our water. So what we want to do is we want to turn this on, and we should see, so it's getting heaty. This should start filling up with water. That's correct. Oh, no, it won't. Because that is the orange. There we go. So orange is output, blue is input. So if you guys to reference, so as you see, that's orange there, which means it's outputting water. Alright, so now we're getting water in our fluid tank, which is good. Now we've got to run water from here all the way to the tender. Don't fill the loco by the cabin, fill it by its tender, because they've got automatically filled to the cabin. These are blue augments that I placed earlier. These are these things here. So you place them there. Then what you do is you go and you smash sections underneath. I generally like to run, I don't like running stuff directly underneath the railway. I prefer to run it down the side. It allows for easy management if slash when stuff goes wrong. Plus, that looks really good because generally nothing gets put underneath rails because it complicates stuff. So what we're doing now is we're going all the way down here. And I think we have one down to the end of this one. So, let's fill it up there. Usually I'll fill this up and make it look pretty. Now we just run our pipe down. Now this can run forever. You don't need a pump to go from the water tower to the loco. All you need is a lever. And we're gonna I like to get this stuff, which is steel scaffolding. And I like to place it above. That way you can see the pipes in there. Now we get our trusty on lever. Put our lever on here, that's off at the moment, yeah. So this should have 72 out of 76,000 levers. You watch when you click this lever, it should start to fill. See, filled up already. That's how quick it is. So, generally, as I said, I put these on top, and that's how you make it look all pretty. And that's pretty much how you set up running water for your train. If you guys have any questions or want to know any further things, just so you cover the mods that I've used here. So all this is from Immersive Engineering, which it has literally all this stuff to use in Immersive Engineering. The train is Immersive Railroading. So literally these two mods is all you need to get this sort of setup. Other than that, take care guys, and leave a thumbs up for the video.